Chevrolet and your Super Chevy dealers proudly present Paradise, Louisiana with Gary Risponi and Don Dubuque. Paradise, Louisiana, powered by Chevrolet, would also like to thank these sponsors.
Simmons Sporting Goods, the South's largest hunting outfitter.
Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Aerial Access, the leader in aerial work process. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Cracker Barrel Convenience Store. We have more than you expect. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana. Farm Bureau Insurance. Louisiana Fish Fry Products. Demco. Area Wholesale Tire Company with tire programs for tire dealers.
Welcome to this week's edition of Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealers. I'm Gary Risponi, and we got a guest host here I've been looking to get here.
Thank you, Mr. Gary. Byron Briggs.
I'm Don Dubuque. This guy looks a little bit different. He doesn't have his camo on, his hat, and his dog by his side.
That's right. It's just a pleasure to be here, Don. I want you to know that.
You know, we got, him's one of the most premier duck hunters in the state. Him and your friend Pat Morrow. I remember one time they hunted out a 60-day season. They hunted 58 days.
Right.
You didn't do too bad on the teal season.
No, we had an excellent teal season this year. Real good.
Well, we're going to be bringing some of that to you. Don, all I got, I had the CCA, and I got reports from him. He was killing them the whole time. So you had a busy week.
Yeah, we're going to kind of recap the teal season. I made a couple of fishing trips, one down in Grand Isle, picked up some nice speckled trout. It's time to head north if you fish along the coast. So there were some good reports, and we'll get to that in the fishing report. People catching a lot of speckled trout still out in the open bays and lakes, but more and more every day we're starting to get better reports of those speckled trout moving in. Redfish is great. We'll talk a little bit about that. But something very important, we got another guest coming in, Randy Myers, who heads up our WMA program for the Department of Wildlife and Fisheries. They are considering having to make some changes in possibly the regulations, season dates, depending on how compromised the habitat and the actual species themselves were. So we'll get a full update from Randy.
Yeah, be that. And then we'll be giving you more on that by next week, because they got to wait on the Wildlife Fisheries Commission going to make the recommendations to them. But look, bow season is open, guys. Bow season is open. Small game season is open. Them rabbits, like they say in French, the lapin.
The lapin.
And Italian is coniglio. Me and Don talked about it many a times right now. The rabbit hunters, a lot of times they wait at the end of the year, but some of them guys have been running their dogs all year. And I'm going to tell you, I remember when I was a young boy, that first rabbit season, it was hot. My daddy said, be careful with those rabbits. Check them for wolves. I don't think that's a problem, do you?
I don't believe it.
Are you seeing a lot of rabbits?
I'm seeing a lot of rabbits, but squirrel season opens up this
And that
this
is
Saturday.
Really big in your neck of the woods over there in Opelousas.
That's correct. And, they also close the schools in Ville Platte, on Fridays because everybody squirrel hunts.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, that little cool snap we had early part of the week sure felt good. That little hint of fall, just wish it would have been here maybe a week or two earlier during
that's
the
right.
teal season.
A lot of people don't realize this. Byron Briggs had his own TV show 7 or 8 years.
Yeah.
Acadiana Outdoors.
Yes, sir.
And out of Opelousas.
Out of Opelousas, right.
In the area. We have borrowed some footage and stuff from you, so when we come back later on, we're going to do a whole segment with you. We're going to do a little retro.
Way back.
Yeah.
All right.
Some of the legends in duck hunting. And one
That's
of them,
right.
Fred Pornell. So, Don,
all right.
That's it.
We got a full show for you. Settle back and get ready. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Now that's what I call a test run.
Silverado, the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickups on the road. So what do you think?
I'll take it.
It's Chevy Truck Month. Now during Chevy Truck Month, get 0% APR financing for 60 months, or qualified buyers can trade up to get the 2012 Chevy Silverado Custom Sport with a total value of $8,000. Hurry in before they're all gone.
These engines run for thousands of hours to prove that we did.
With 20% more cleaning agents than before, Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline.
Protects your engine better!
Awkward.
Try new Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines.
No other gasoline protects your engine better.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading hunting or fishing.
Aerial Access Equipment has been serving Louisiana, the Mississippi Gulf Coast, and Southeast Texas since 1998. Our trained sales staff has the expertise necessary to ensure our customers get the right piece of equipment for the job at competitive rental rates. Need help with choosing the right machine for the job? We'll come to your job site and recommend the right machine to meet your needs. Remember, quality, reliability, safety. Aerial Access Equipment, your aerial work platform and forklift specialist.
And welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and time to go catch a few speckled trout. Byron, you like fishing speckled trout?
Oh, yes, sir. Man, that's fun, huh?
Just don't have many around Ville Platte, Opelousas.
No,
you
got to
go
many.
A little ride to
that's
get
right.
them, huh?
He got about four boats. He's always buying a deal of boats. He fishes with David O'Leary, a good friend.
Oh, yeah,
there,
we go down to
where most of your speckled trout fishing is?
Well, I fish with David, and we fish out of Sycamore Point. Mm-hmm. In Freshwater City.
You know, man's got to have more than one boat if you live in Louisiana, right?
That's
I
right.
mean, one boat just don't
no,
get it. You
got
to go offshore. You got to fish along the coastal bays. You got to get up into the marshes with a flat bottom boat.
You gotta,
and you need a bass boat to catch bass
right.
and sackle
boat.
And a kayak now,
right.
too.
You got to have money like mine.
No.
Mine's big. You got one of the biggest.
Either that or
have
a lot of good friends.
Yeah.
If y'all want to borrow money, y'all go.
Yeah, he's blowing smoke now.
Well, I got to make a speckled trout trip last week with Captain Don Sutton, one of the up-and-coming captains, works with Darryl Carpenter, one of our friends down in Grand Isle, realscreamers.com. And the plan was we could have had a choice, could have went after the redfish, could have went after the speckled trout. I told him redfish is too easy right now. Let's go for a real challenge. So we went for the speckled trout, grabbed up some beautiful live shrimp. I mean, you've seen those shrimp Buggy Vega has down there at the Bridgeside Marina. Right now they got those big, juicy, delicious white shrimp. And it was all I could do to keep from putting them in my ice chest and taking them home and forgetting the fish.
If you start catching them on plastics, you can always eat them.
Well, you can use the plastics, but we went with the live bait, went to Bay Rambo, went to Palmetto, some of the typical wintertime fishing spots, and you can catch them in the fall. Found a good many trout anywhere from 10 inches to a keeper 12 on up to 16-inch trout. Fishing pretty simple, basically under a popping cork, about 2 foot down. And then we also went to Carolina rigging. You got to be careful fishing some of those areas with the Carolina because you're fishing over a lot of oyster reefs. And they'll eat up your tackle if you're fishing there. It's better to use that cork and suspend it over there.
You know them gates at Palmetto, a lot of times it used to be you restricted. You can't get in.
It's still that way.
A lot of those people fish the outside of those.
Right.
There's some deeper holes. And some of the bigger trout was out there. You can go in some of that water 20 foot deep. Used to be, but now since the hurricanes, they used to have a lease right there. Lake Inferma and around mm-hmm. Palmetto. It's outstanding fishing. It starts in October and runs till it gets real, real cold around December. Now redfish stay there all year long,
right.
But the speckled trout they move.
Sound like you fished there before?
Oh, a bunch of times. I used to have a lease. I used to fish there every Friday and Saturday.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, you can access it from Leeville or you can access it from Grand Isle, but you're right. If you're going to fish speckled trout down there, right now they're still kind of hit and miss along the beach because there's a lot of bait along there. The backside of the island, still catch some fish. Four bayous, fairly consistent. But if you want to make sure you're going to get into some fish, that's probably your best bet is to go north to those areas there. We're going to take you there right now. Here he is, Captain Don Sutton and I at Grand Isle catching speckled trout. I don't like the way he's hanging down, though. Ooh, a big trout. All right, now you come down here to Grand Isle in the spring and summer months. The island itself, the beaches are ground zero for speckled trout. But once that transition starts, like it does all along the coast, you got to follow the trout, and to do that, you head north. All right, speckled trout in transition. We'll show you.
tell you what, they're staying down like a catfish.
Yeah, they ain't coming up. It's trout.
I don't know if this is a trout. There's no way this is a trout.
I don't know.
No head shape.
Oh. I'm gonna get that net ready.
Yeah, we got it ready.
It's not a catfish. I think it's a trout, though. I think I got it. This is a trout. It's the one I've been looking
for.
Nope,
sheephead.
Yeah.
Shepherd.
Doing out there in the middle of.
Like a little
trout.
Some trout. It wasn't that bad. Believe me. You got one already?
Oh, yeah.
Good for you. First cast, that's bad luck. I hate that.
Yeah.
He gonna keep? There he is, all right. So, if you're not gonna be doing any beach fishing, you can still launch your boat at Grand Isle, get your bait, and then head north, and here's what you're gonna find, transition speckled trout.
Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
Get more for your buck while the hunt is on at Simmons Sporting Goods. Hunt undetected in a new Scentlock Mirage jacket or pant. Your choice, only $149.99. New for primitive weapon season, the CVA Stalker. Camo stainless with rings and base in 35 wheeling, only $349.99. Or the CVA Elite Stalker, just $279.99. We're open till 6, Monday through Saturday, and Sunday from noon to 5. Or shop all the store-wide savings at SimmonsSportingGoods.com.
Of all the tools in your house, this could easily be the most dangerous, but it doesn't have to be. At Dimco, we can't stress this enough. Just keep it and you far away from power lines.
Dimco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Joining us now is Randy Myers with the Wildlife Division of Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries to tell us what plans, if any, changes may occur on our wildlife management areas as a result of Hurricane Isaac. Randy, first of all, how is access to the management areas? Are there going to be problems that hunters are going to be faced with trying to get on those areas?
Don, we pretty much, our department, have been active in getting out and making sure that access is available in our wildlife management areas. As most of you are aware, this storm was more of a water event, more so than a wind event. So a lot of the issues dealt mainly with floodwaters that may have inundated or impacted some of our major roadways. We've been out actively looking at those, assessing the damage, and trying to get those back in shape. So most of the hunters should see very limited impact to our access. In fact, all of our wildlife management areas are open at this time.
What about the management areas specifically? Which one should people be concerned about that may experience some changes when they get ready to enter them for the hunting season?
In the southeast part of our state, where most of the impact, obviously, from the storm when it came ashore, we have Pearl River Wildlife Management Area. We had some road damage there that we're actively trying to, you know, get in place, put some more limestone down, do some grading, get the washboard effect, you know, in check so that our vehicles can get down. We have a few trails that may be impacted with some downed trees. Tunica Hills Wildlife Management Area is one to come to mind, particularly on the north track. We are at this moment, you know, working with some to get out there with a bulldozer and get those trails cleared.
I was just wondering, how important, or is any secrets to getting in these places, or things that you think hunters need to know? Besides, anything changed at all that they need to know?
As far as access, no, we don't have any major issues. What we're mainly concerned with is what impact the storm may have had with our deer herd. We've been out actively assessing the impact of that storm, the high waters to the deer resources and within, you know, a pretty broad area in the southeast part of the state.
Is there any news in the northern part of the state that ain't even affected by the storm that you want to get out, or news that wildlife fisheries would like to get out?
As far as the impact from the storm, the good news about the storm was that it brought a lot of rain with it. And at a time when we had some significant drought in the north part of the state, the rains were actually helpful and providing some early habitat for the teal that came down, and hopefully it will hold over for the big ducks. So that's one of the things that we're anticipating.
If there are going to be any adjustments made to season dates, maybe even limits or that type of thing, what criteria will you use to make those determinations?
Don, what we have actually gone out by foot, we've gone out by boat, and as well as aerial reconnaissance, looking at the habitat, looking for dead deer, any impact to not only deer but rabbits, nutria, anything that the department is concerned with, alligator resources as well as our fish resources. We've interviewed hunters. We've actually discussed the impacts with our enforcement division folks that were out there during that time frame, got reports from the general public and in addition to the information and data that we've collected and went out and to assess the habitat as well as the direct impact to the resource.
What about something on a positive note, the damage like to the nutria or to nuisance animals? Is that help? What about the hogs? Some things down in the marsh in the southeast. The hogs were getting bad. Did it do some damage to them?
We did note some mortality directly to the wild hogs, but they were very resilient. We saw that after Hurricane Katrina. Everyone, that's kind of the mark now is relative to Hurricane Katrina. The hogs survived very well, particularly in the Pearl River area. It's one of those situations where we don't think that there was a big impact to the feral hog population. But we do know that there were some impact to the nutria along the coast. We saw a lot of nutria that were killed because of the high waters.
Well, to kind of wrap up, based on your observations, you're going to give that assessment information to the commission this week. They will formally recommend or actually vote on whether they will make those changes, if any changes are suggested. Now, how will sportsmen be able to find out that information? Because we're right on the small game season, archery season's open. If their management area that they are used to hunting on is going to be affected, how can they find out?
We will do everything we can to work with the media. We're very active in working with you guys and trying to get that word out when we do have impact to of our mm-hmm. wildlife management areas or even the season that's on the outside. We will post it on the internet, and we will do any type of radio shows, anything to get the word out, mm-hmm. As well as all of our region offices will have that information available.
Thursday evening, October 4th, it ought to already be, the website.
So that's
you
correct.
Can find out.
Check
that's
it
correct.
On the website. I'll have it on my radio show Saturday morning. Of course, you can get all the full information here next week. Thank you for being with us, Randy. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Randy Myers, Wildlife and Fisheries Program Manager for the WMAs. We'll be right back. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Louisiana.
Mr. Gary, we're going to miss the morning bite. If you want food and snacks, we better hurry up.
I tell you what, you pump the gas, I'll get the food.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
When did insurance companies start emailing handshakes? Why is a billboard the only place you see your agent's face? Who decided you can't have good rates and good coverage? If you're questioning your insurance options, get real answers from a real person with a Farm Bureau confidential insurance review. It's simple, quick, and tailored just for you. Call today. Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service. Real people.
We build tires, but not like anybody else. We build our tires for people. People with places to go and reasons to get there. Like get up to $75 back on 4 qualifying Cooper tires during our Take the Money and Ride event. Get your rebate form and complete terms and conditions at a participating Cooper Tire dealer or CooperTireRebates.com. Life's a road trip. Come on. Let's go.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, powered by your Super Chevy dealer. Mr. Brian Briggs, you know, before we get to talking about the old times, let's talk about till season right now. Don, and you just coming off one of the greatest till seasons we had in a long time.
That's right.
I think out of all days you hunted, we had 16-day till season. I know of one day that you said had a bad day. You tried a new area, y'all killed one till.
Right, yes, sir. We had one bad day.
Now, you took me on opening day. We had a great hunt, and you went back the next day with the judge, Judge Daugherty, and Pat. And then you started on Monday. You started back. You tried another place. You had Palmetto. You had David O'Lynn.
Right.
Tell us your take, because you had so many different places to hunt, about where you hunt and what's your take on the till season.
Well, this year we're very fortunate. We have a lot of teal came in. I mean, we have an increase. We increased up to 9.2 million teal this year compared to 6 million last year. The state was covered in teal, just to be honest with you. Most people in the Jennings area, like we talked about, everybody just about limited out every day. And it was excellent.
I think what even put more teal into that area was the southeastern part of the state, because of Isaac, for the first week of the season, was pretty much devoid of teal. And I think those birds pushed even more over there.
That's
so
right.
With the breeding population success and then the conditions that we had, it was great in parts of the state.
You know, we've had the largest teal concentration this year since 1956. So that's saying some for the birds that we have, the blue-winged teal, and it's just really helping out our duck hunting season altogether, too, for the next season.
Yeah, you know, we hunted the Delta Plantation up there north in Catahoula. They killed some birds. They didn't have any water. Where I went to Mur Rouge, went in there, had wherever they had water, they had a few teal. Brian, you have so many different places to hunt. You've been doing it all your life, and I'm envious,
okay?
And we sure are doing it. But you do share your resources. I'm going to say, you had, you know, especially with your grandkids and your kids, and that's always first with anybody.
That's right.
But the places you have to hunt, name some of the places. You and Pat, I mean, that's your passion. You know, y'all two were all outdoors. I made rabbit hunts with you.
Right.
Your son took a handicap, a nephew of mine. Y'all took him out on a deer hunt. He killed a big 7-point.
Right.
You know, but you were involved in all the outdoors, and you did that with your show. But talking about ducks in particular, name me some of the places. And you still buying land or still looking at places. Right. How you decide where you're going to hunt?
Well, I'll give you an example. Years ago, a friend, David McCann, from up at Knowlton, Delhi area, I had a camp up on the Yucatan, up along the Mississippi River, and there was a lot of birds would fly the river. Mm-hmm. And after a number of years, the birds switched over and started going to the middle of the state, in Oklahoma and Texas. And so I had to give that area up, and I moved in the middle of the state and started hunting this area. And because it really fell off up there. So and the birds move and hopefully I can still move with them, you know.
Well, where is your favorite places to hunt? I mean, now you got places in the marsh, you got it down around Opelousas. Yeah. I know where you live in Palmetto. You had the swamp,
right?
Your timber hunt. You got Teal Lake, which is beautiful. You got rice fields. And you even bought a place up in Catahoula.
Right.
Talking to a guy up in Monroe.
Yeah.
But, and I was saying, you have so many places to hunt. You just keep up with the ducks, and that's what you do?
I try to keep up with them, and that's why one day we didn't kill our limit this year. Because, I mean, I didn't know where, you know, mm-hmm. you just hit it. But I like timber hunting. That's my favorite, instead of rice field. I mean, rice field hunting is good. But I just, it's something about that timber and working those birds and making them come right in. And a good friend of mine, Jason Campbell, he's a mm-hmm. state champion duck caller.
Multiple times state
that's
champion.
That's right.
And goose caller.
And Jason's a real good guy, and he teaches a lot of people and a lot of kids on how to call ducks. Of course, we saw him down at
the Gate Island Duck Festival. Oh, yeah, a lot of those kids festival. In the junior division, they give credit to Jason.
And he's really bringing the sport forward.
It helped you, you bring it up, dog training?
That's right.
Well, Byron, you mentioned, the 9.2 million teal, the most since they've ever been counting. You got to be really excited about the rest of the ducks, too, for the big suck season coming, because we had droughts north of here. The population is up. Right. Are you really excited and thinking we're going to have a banner year this year?
Okay, now, the mallards. Let's talk about the mallards.
Is that your favorite bird, mallard?
But we just don't get them anymore. I mean, there's a little over 10 million mallards this year they counted. And it's an increase of 15%. Now on the gadwall, you know, we're starting to get a lot more gadwall, and there's about almost 4 million gadwall that they estimated this year, which is up about 15 to 20%. So we're going to get a lot of gadwall down. We're going to get a lot of blue-winged teal, and we're going to get a lot of spoonbills. So that's going to be our main ducks that we're going to have this coming year. That's just my opinion.
No, I think you're right. Yeah. Well. We're looking forward to it and hope we can maybe make a hunt with you down there. Can I bring Hokie Guy? He's the father of the spoonbill nation,
right.
I'm calling.
I'll tell you what, that's what we need.
Yeah, you know, that's what I was going to ask you. You know, you invite so many different people and you take and you try to spread it out and you get frustrated sometimes. You say, well, I got five people who want to go with this and that. And I know that's really hard on you because you're so nice a guy. But, You ought to get invited on some hunts. Didn't people invite you on any?
Oh yeah, I get invited on some hunts but a lot of times I have so many people I need to bring that it's kind of, I'm like Don. Don gets so many invitations, you know, that we have to.
I'm hoping we can put 8 days in a week. That's all I need.
Yeah, that's
just another
that's
day
right.
in a week.
Look, we're gonna come back. We're gonna do a little retro. We're gonna go back with you hunting some of the old footage that you hunted in the timber. And we're one of the legends of hunting, Mr. Fred Pornell. So stay tuned. We're going to come back one more little short segment with Mr. Byron Brick.
Now that's what I call a test drive.
Silverado, the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickups on the road. So what do you think?
I'll take it.
It's Chevy Truck Month. Now during Chevy Truck Month, get 0% APR financing for 60 months or qualified buyers can trade up to get the 2012 Chevy Silverado Custom Sport with a total value of $8,000. Hurry in before they're all gone.
The 2012 Louisiana Saltwater Series is the state's premier saltwater tournament. Hosted by the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries, this is a catch, tag, and release tournament. There are six qualifying events held across the state's coast, plus a championship. Entry fee is $200 for each two-man team, plus there's a youth division of two anglers under 16 per team. This is a 100% payout plus prize tournament. For details and to register, visit lasaltwaterseries.com.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with four electrolytes lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4, the complete sports drink.
See what you've been missing.
spring when the hunt is on at Simmons Sporting Goods. Hunt like a pro for less with the Moultrie Pro Hunter Tripod Feeder, only $89.99. Plan your hunt with the Moultrie GameSpy D55 Infrared Camera, now $119.99. See just how big he is with the Moultrie Big Game Scale, a low $16.99. And big things come in small packages like the Moultrie Minicam M80 XT, just $129.99. Shop all the store-wide savings at SimmonsSportingGoods.com.
Talking about duck calling and talking about duck hunting right here with Mr. Byron Briggs. Byron, in your show, I've seen some outstanding footage. You loaned me. I've seen some really outstanding footage, but none better than the one hunt you did with Fred Pornell. By the way, Don, like you were saying, the only person from Louisiana to ever win the World Duck Calling Championship. But, Brian, tell us about this hunt and where y'all were at and how y'all set this hunt up. You had his sidekick with you, too, and everybody that knew Fred Pornell knew about his sidekick. And he was another one like you.
Oh, yeah.
He hunted duck wherever he had an invitation. He had places all over from the Yucatan all the way down to the Gator.
Oh, yeah. Fred was a real trip, I can tell you. And Fred always had Bilo with him. Bilo was a ninja that Fred went down to the Yucatan, and Bilo was one of his guides, and he brought him back, and that's what he did. He went out and helped Fred to set up his blinds, do all this type of stuff. But he was a real unique hunter, and he knew how to hunt, and he showed a lot of people how to hunt. And he was the only world champion from Louisiana. I know we talked about that.
Right, yeah, they hold it in Stuttgart, Arkansas every year, and you know every state gets to send someone there. Mike Smith has been a 5-time state duck calling champion. We've had other people that have won here in Louisiana.
Talk about
had
Jason
high hopes.
Campbell.
Jason Campbell,
the,
we
the
send them up
division.
There. Yeah. And they just can't come back with a victory. And
no.
Fred did it back in the 50s, if I'm not mistaken.
I think it was 54 or something in that neighborhood, you know, and he was quite a...
What kind of a shot was he? Was he a good
shot? Yeah, he was a good shot. And let me tell you something else. When we would call in some mallards in the swamp, and we were hunting up, we hunted in North Louisiana a lot in different places, and we called him in, and one morning we called him in, and he says, "Okay, dude, it's your time to shoot." And I got up, and I laid three of them on the water. He said, "Uh-uh, no more." He said, "When you call a gang of mallards in, we're going to shoot one. We got to make this thing last." So that's how he was. And so we pick out the greenhead, and we shoot one, and then let the rest go.
I remember that. Hey, dude.
You remember that?
Oh, yeah, I remember, dude. But tell us about this hunt. This hunt was set up. It was beautiful. The scenery was beautiful. Yeah. You had people in stumps and everything. Tell us more about this hunt.
Yeah, we were hunting up on the... in some flooded timber up on the Mississippi River, and this was one of my old shows, and we went ahead and I filmed this show up there with Fred and his brother and Bilo, and we had a good time. We killed our limit of mallards that morning, and it was just a pretty show, and we just enjoyed it.
Did you get that on film?
No.
What did it?
Shot, Mr. Fred.
Like here.
This ain't the same flight either.
No, though. No, hell no. But they were all here for opening day when they left. Now let's get these.
It's 8:30. Look at his light out there.
It's 8:30. And 8:30, it's 8:29. 8:30 flight's going to be here in a few minutes.
Wait.
You can shoot a pass. Just cut a pass. Wait.
Did you get some good film?
Yeah, come on.
Listen.
I want to see
a listen, tell me when you want me to call the mallard all in. We've been calling Pete.
There's two green heads there.
I can't get it. My blind's too high.
Too high.
Did you get that?
With this up in you. I ain't get it.
Yeah. Get up high. Get that bump like that. Good Lord, boy. Just look at him right here, Eli. Get this all this back here.
Mr. Fred, those guys have to take us out of here.
Huh?
They're able to attack us.
Mr. Fred, the ducks are still pouring in right now.
Don't tell me, I'm looking at them.
It's unbelievable. You know, we hope everybody enjoyed our show this week. We limited out on mallards and our off ducks. And, and they got ducks everywhere.
Oh, look at the ducks.
One of those perfect days,
right.
Perfect company.
Bluebird
There's
day.
Not a lot of them in your lifetime,
right.
But boy, you just never forget them. Any other memorable hunts, ones that really stand out in your mind?
Yeah, I did a lot of I mean, I did some, I was kind
of
like you, Don, with your radio shows. I did it for 8 years and have numerous, hunting and fishing shows and a lot of fun. And, you know, what y'all do right here, a lot of people can't appreciate it. But I can because it's a lot of work and I appreciate it.
I got one serious question before we get out of here, and I'm going to put you on the spot. You know, a lot of people think, and Don has the same thing, man, y'all got the best job in the world. Y'all hunt and fish all the time and get paid. You
right.
know?
If
that is true,
yeah.
If that is true, after 8 years, man, I know you got a lot of money. You don't need the money.
No.
So, and you retired,
yeah.
You know, from work. But why did you give it up?
Well,
so these people out there think it's so easy. Well, why?
No, it's not easy, I promise you. You know, when you get up in the morning, you got to have your camera guys go with you. I mean, you have to equip them. They have to have waders on. You got to hide them in the bushes. Everything has to be set up just right to make that video. And you have to make a show every week.
But you see, you said the secret. You can't get a cameraman. Who shot this footage?
I did a lot of shooting.
You shot that shooting, so you don't have the gun. I'm one of the guys that want to be on the gun a little bit more.
That's right.
Or catching fish. And one of my favorite shows, I didn't hardly have to pick up a rider, with Don, D. Cohagen, Hill Wagner, and Dudley Vanderbilt right after Hurricane Katrina to watch these guys. I mean, Dudley was almost crying. They were so happy the fish were back. And I watched these guys shoot. That's fun.
Oh, yeah.
It's fun. I wouldn't be doing it.
That's right.
Not a whole lot of money yet. But I'm going to be like you.
No.
I'm going to be like you one day.
No, you done made the big bucks, I can tell you.
Right. But, Brian, I would thank you for being a guest. We're going to come back later with the fishing report. Am I right, Don? Have we got any other segments?
I don't know if I'm going to be here for the next segment. Y'all done told me this is so much hard work. I didn't realize that. I'm going to get me an easy job.
That's
maybe
right.
One way I can go work in a high rise down in Baton Rouge or New Orleans, wear a tie every day and
you
sit in traffic. If anybody got a job offer, let me know.
Yeah.
I'm ready to go.
You or I both can't keep up with this.
Oh, no. I know that.
Too much irons in the fire.
All right. We'll be right back. You're watching Paradise Louisiana.
not like anybody else. We build our tires for people. People with places to go and reasons to get there. Like get up to $75 back on 4 qualifying Cooper tires during our Take the Money and Ride event. Get your rebate form and complete terms and conditions at a participating Cooper Tire dealer or CooperTireRebates.com. Life's a road trip. Come on, let's go.
Ask me about my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
I like it.
Nothing's better than boiled seafood. Spiced just right.
Oh, yeah.
And Louisiana Fish Fry Products makes it easy to boil right every time.
Can't get enough.
Grab a bag. There's nothing to mix. Just pour and boil.
Aw, now you're cooking.
Crawfish, crab, or shrimp. With Louisiana Fish Fry Products, you got boiling down easy.
That's the way.
And welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana. Welcoming in our guest host this week, Byron Briggs. Glad to have you with us.
Appreciate it.
Got a lot of things coming up in Louisiana. We're into the fall season now.
We just started checking the schedules. You know, we got CCA banquets still going mm-hmm. on. Delta Waterfowl banquets are right. going on right there by you. And definitely Ducks Unlimited banquets is going on. But Don, I'm gonna tell you right now, we've talked about fishing and things you're doing. The Ladies Rodeo just coming weekend right now. Grand Isle Ladies Rodeo. October 5th and 6th, starts on the 5th, that's a Friday, and then goes through Saturday, and I know y'all guys worried about the LSU, the LSU ball game during the rodeo. Buggy, at Bridgeside, they'll have TVs everywhere, people watching ball games, ladies having fun. Every year there's always a game going on at LSU, one of the most fun times you ever do, and it all benefits cancer research for the ladies.
Same weekend, Louisiana Sportsman Series Redfish wraps up in Venice.
Oh, that's a big one. And
I'll be down there. Yeah, come on down and see us at the
event. I'll be at Grand Island. You know, it's a handicap hunt to be going on right now, so we'll be bringing you some of the people a handicap hunt. They got a wild night out. This is something different. The Louisiana Wildlife and Fisheries Foundation, where they give the money for the Saltwater Series, all the youth education, and youth mm-hmm. hunting awards. They got a number you can dial. I'm going to write it down here real quick. I'm going to run it on the screen. That's better than that. But I forgot to write it down. But let me tell you what. It's the foundation, and these are people that belong to every organization you can imagine. They go out there, and this money goes forth to helping some of the programs that the wildlife fishers have where they don't have the dollars sufficient to do it. So it's a big, great, great thing doing it out, and we'll run a number. That's going to be October 11th Live Oak Aradium on Jefferson Highway. By the way, and then we got the State Star Banquet Barbecue will be coming up on the 25th, the same place, Live Oak Aradium. That's two of the big events I know that I don't want to believe should be missed.
Oh, I'll tell you what else we got too that's coming for the first time in Louisiana, the HT3 Redfish Series. They're going to call it the H2O Shock. It's the Redfish Championship. We're going to have 50 teams coming down here to fish out of the dock in Slidell. My condolences to Pensacola. They had this event. They've lost it. It's now in Louisiana this year and maybe next year at the dock in Slidell. The St. Tammany Parish Tourism Commission has jumped in on this thing. They've actually made a festival out of it. They're going to have live music. I'm going to be doing radio broadcasts out there all day long. They're going to have events. You know, Danica Bailey and the crew from Wildlife and Fisheries is going to be out there with things for the kids to do. So it's going to be at the dock, and it begins on the 10th and runs all the way through the 13th. That final day, that Saturday, they're going to cut down to the top 10 teams, and they'll be fishing for somewhere in the neighborhood of $50,000 prizes. So that's a very exciting event we got coming on. Of course, we got a lot of hunting things coming up, too. We opened up the archery season this past week. Squirrel season opens up this weekend, which is really big. In fact, this is the weekend of the squirrel rodeo that the East Ascension Sportsman League. I don't know if you ever heard of that before.
No.
You get your eight squirrels, you bring them in, and you weigh them in like a fishing rodeo.
No kidding.
It's a tournament. Then they cook.
Oh, you know,
sometimes they get tired. They come back on Sunday and cook. And October 3rd. If you're free, you go down and get it down there. But look, I want y'all to see this right here. This is that. I want to thank Dave Mullen, by the way, standing in for us at Waddell the other day. This is his book. We're talking about it. Don got all of them. He says, show his book and where you can get it. Louisiana Whitetail. This is a great book right now. Booth season is hot and going. And the big deer season is right around the corner. One of the most informative books. I'm talking about food plots and everything else you want to do. Yeah, this is something you want to do. By the way, I listened to Danica Bailey Williams on your show the other day. I was anxious to know how many fish were caught at the city park.
Yeah, they had a cichlids roundup there, which I don't know if you have those over there where you are. It's a Rio Grande perch is another name for it. And they suspect that these things got turned loose from people with aquariums. They got into our fresh water, and they're just like a lot of other things that come to Louisiana. Yeah. They make more of them, and they don't ever want to leave. The only thing that stops their spread is cold water. Like the North Shore area, it's too water. Maybe the water's too cold by you for them to survive year-round, and salt water. But outside of that, they're actually out-competing our native brim species.
Really?
Our bluegill perch, our goggle eyes, the chinkapins. They're kind of squeezing them on out, and they've gotten into the lagoons in City Park in New Orleans and just overpopulated. So in an effort to, they know they're not going to ever completely get them out of there, but to kind of keep them in check, they put on a rodeo and invited people to come out and catch as many as you want. There's no limits on them, and get them out of there and take them home and eat them. Now, the good part about it is they fight real hard, and they're pretty good to eat.
And you can fish them any time of the year. That's why I'm mentioning it right now. Too late for the little rodeo, the contest they had, and I'm going to tell Danica Williams, by the way, Danica, you forgot to let us know a little bit about that. He does such a great job at everything. Danica, I want to compliment you on all the stuff you do and look forward to doing more with Danica. You know, she's that Worcester fish and everything else. And I hear Manny's back running the saltwater series too.
Oh, don't forget, while you're talking about saltwater series, October 20th, they're going to have the Louisiana Speckled Trout, the Louisiana Saltwater Series at the Seabrook Harbor Marina. It's $100 per boat. That's your two-man team. You can have four if you bring two kids. So there's lots to do, and keep watching us, and we'll keep you up to date in the month of October on into the fall. Lots of things to see and do, and you're seeing it right here on Paradise, Louisiana.
Now that's what I call a test drive.
Silverado, the most dependable, longest-lasting full-size pickups on the road. So what do you think?
I'll take it.
It's Chevy Truck Month. Now during Chevy Truck Month, get 0% APR financing for 60 months or qualified buyers can trade up to get the 2012 Chevy Silverado Custom Sport with a total value of $8,000. Hurry in before they're all gone.
Mr. Gay, we're going to miss the morning bite. If you want food and snacks, we better hurry up.
I'll tell you what, you pump the gas, I'll get the food.
Visit Cracker Barrel convenience stores before heading fishing or hunting. We have more than you expect.
Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change has been keeping cars and trucks in Baton Rouge clean and running smooth for over 50 years. At Benny's, we feature professional car washing, complete detailing, high-tech waxing and buffing, interior cleaning, and tire shine. Benny's, one stop for car maintenance with complete oil and lube services and even state inspections at our express locations. Visit one of our five convenient locations, including our newest store on Greenwell Springs Road. And don't forget to stop by Be Quick Convenience Store and Fuel Stop. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Drive in dirty, drive out clean.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
Now, every September, Louisiana sportsmen have a tough choice to make. Do you take advantage of the early migrating teal during the special teal season, or do you get those redfish? Well, some of us do both, and we call it a blast and cast.
It gives you an opportunity to check your dog and you know, little things like that. If you have a couple of bad habits, you got 6 weeks to fix it. If you got trouble with a boat or something, you know, you have time to get the kinks out before the big season. So it's a great warm-up and, you know, get your eye right a little bit, you know, that kind of thing.
All right, we're actually catching redfish in the Mississippi River. When you think of the Mississippi River, you're thinking catfish and freshwater species, but right now it's pure saltwater.
The saltwater wedge is backing in. When it does, all the fish come out the marsh because this water is just pristine. So you, as you can see, there's just thousands and thousands of mullets. You got black tips and bull sharks, redfish, jack crevalle. You still got some bass in here, giant catfish. So it's fun to fish. You know, it's relaxing to me. I can drift down here and catch a load of fish. And historically, I don't know what it's going to be like after the spill, but historically the trout will come here and here later on. And if they do that, it will be fire.
All right, so if you see some guys out in camouflage, it's not to hide from the fish. They've been out blasting and casting for redfish in the river. And what you were just watching was our fishing trip with Ryan Lambert down in the Mississippi River. We were catching redfish along those rocks, slow rolling spinnerbaits, kind of like bass fishing in the Mississippi River, a place where you don't normally find redfish, but there's a saltwater wedge. This time of the year when the river drops, that saltwater moves up, and with it comes the bait, and with it comes the fish, and that should be going on for a while. And speaking of redfish, they are all over the place.
Oh, man, I'm telling you what, but you're talking about fishing the rocks. You're talking about catching freshwater fish, too, the same place. I can remember fishing with Joel Campanile, Ascension Marine. Him and I fished the rocks one day, and we were watching this guy catching catfish with shrimp. And he was catching river cat, you know, blue channel cat, while he was catching them. And we were, and he'd catch a redfish every now and then. But Joel and I were fishing a spinnerbait and a rattle trap. When we were fishing the rocks, we caught a limit of bass, a limit of redfish, and a limit of specks. Plus, we caught four or five stripers fishing just a spinnerbait and them on that rock.
It's not unusual to catch redfish and bass in the same water, but to catch speckled trout in there with them, too, that's really unusual. But that's that layering effect where that salt water, you're deeper and the fresh water's
up. Well, right now, that redfish take over right now with that salt water.
While we're on venison, talking a little bit about bass fishing, we don't like to give you bad reports, but there's some bad news. Hurricane Isaac and that salt water surge really did a number on the bass fishing down in Venice. The good news is that area is continually replenished with Mississippi River water and fish, so could be next spring, maybe later in the next part of next year before that really rebounds.
Sometimes
down
even
there.
Faster than that. The biggest part about it is even with the ducks, you know, it's the aquatic, the grass, you know, the good grass, the wigeon grass, and the and the hydrilla, and all them places are back, and we're just coming back, and that's a lot of places where the bass congregate.
Right.
So we hope it comes back, Don.
Well, more good news. Speckled trout, as we showed you earlier, moving in north along the coast. You're going to be finding them more and more on the inside. So speckled trout fishing is good. Fishing behind the shrimp boats, they're still catching yellowfin, blackfin tuna. When you can get out, the offshore fishing's been good. What you got on freshwater? You might tell us a little bit about
freshwater. Well, I'm going to tell you what. I'm telling on saltwater. We finally went asking Captain Steve Smith to give us a report of Vermilion Bay, one of the places you fish. He's sending me some pictures right now. He got a limit of fish right in the bay itself, in Vermilion Bay, and fishing the same areas he does. I can't name all of them he fishes, but same places they're starting to move in. And the bonus is right now, they're fishing on the bottom. They're fishing plastics. They're fishing sparkle color plastic, fishing on the bottom, and they're catching trout, but they're also catching some nice white trout, so it add to your limit.
I almost didn't want to forget to talk about Cocodry, too. They're doing real good over there. Bayou Du Large, which is a really good hot winter spot, that area is starting to come around. Sister Lake, getting good reports of both specks and reds there. And out west, Lake Prien, Calcasieu, they're doing it over there, too, on both the reds and the specks.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to give you now freshwater. In North Louisiana, doing great, but the spillway is still the highest thing I know. I know I talked to Chef KD. He still, every Monday when he get off, except for this Monday, the poor thing got to work. But he's complaining now. This is Monday, is the day off, and nobody works harder than KD. But they are still catching saccalay. And I'm talking about they're catching from Pigeon all the way south to Little Saw, back down in the lower part of the spillway. Joe and them fished with Crochet, and they fished in Pigeon area. They fished in spinnerbait up on the bank. Or they punching. Punching is a big thing right now. Them fish are moving up on the bank. When the sun comes up, you know, they moving out. So that's when Joe was finding little bitty spots of grass, he was saying, and they were fishing that spinnerbait over those little patches of grass. Mm-hmm. And when I'm talking about catching fish, they're catching 40 and 50 Ooh, wow. fish, but they might have five keepers.
Yeah.
Well, I hope we've given you a lot of choices to do. It's October. It's a pretty month. Got some good weather. Offshore, saltwater, freshwater, and the hunting seasons are here. So get ready. We got a lot to do.
I want to give a shout out to my buddy Darrell Jans and his son Austin. They had a trainer. We go with them. They finally made the hunter retriever title. They got it on his dog. His dog is named Remington. I hunted with Remington last year. I forgot he was coming around there. By the way, let me get the trainer the name right here. His name is Todd Smith. I've written in here. I'm getting terrible. Well, I'm messing up. I was doing good all the time. Todd Smith. That's it. I want to get that hot out.
Well, congratulations to
Don. You named that. It's called Delutra Labs. Mm-hmm. It's the trainers down there in Spearsville. Well, where Spearsville is. Keep going.
We'll get you.
What are you telling me?
We'll
keep
your
going
GPS.
Or get out of here.
Myron, thanks for coming by. Really enjoyed it. Look forward to seeing you during the season.
Mr. Gary, thank you again.
I did good. I messed that fourth quarter up.
Oh, you did good.
I appreciate it.
All right, buddy.
You give me some tips?
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you all for being here. Come back and see us next week.
More important, invite us on Easy.
All right.
Paradise, Louisiana, powered by Chevrolet, would also like to thank these sponsors.
Simmons Sporting Goods, the South's largest hunting outfitter.
Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Aerial Access, the leader in aerial work process. Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change. Cracker Barrel Convenience Store. We have more than you expect. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Louisiana. Farm Bureau Insurance. Louisiana Fish Fry Products. Demco. Area Wholesale Tire Company with tire programs for tire dealers.